It's the G to the U to the R to the U. Now I got to talk about, you know, one of the greatest underachievers, man. From one of the greatest overachievers to one of the greatest underachievers of all time in Cam Newton. And Cameron Darrell Newton re-signed a one-year deal with the New England Patriots. So it's Cam and Bill part two. So when I was thinking about this, man, it got me, you know me. I'm always thinking. That's what they do. I'm the thinker, man. Let me do my thing. You know, I'm the thinker. You know, just thinking, man. My little thinking pose. You guys on the audio, you can't see that, man. But what this got me thinking, bro, it's like it brought me back into the guru. You know, while back in my guru's adolescent stage, man. Adolescent stage. I used to always go to my aunt's house. You know, for the summertime. From the summertime, we used to go to my aunt's house, man. She used to live in Jamaica. What was it? Jamaica, Queens, man, in New York. Jamaica, Queens, man. Early in my childhood, man. I used to go there in the summertime in New York, man. You know the good, a D.C. guy, man. D.C. area guy. So we went to New York. So every summer, we used to spend about a month there. You know, I used to spend a month there, right? And then there was this one summer, man. There was this one young lady. This one young girl, she was a little Puerto Rican girl. Puerto Rican-ass mama, man. I'm talking about she was a 15-year-old. Ah, bah, 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 bah. Yeah, you know how them Latinas, when they're 15, they look like they're 25. Yeah, I was like, oh, my God, that's a grown-ass woman. Yeah. So we have this little connection, man. We had a connection. You know what I'm saying? And we just, some people call it a summer fling. A summer fling. So when I look at Cam Newton to the New England Patriots and Bill Belichick, this kind of reminded me of my summer swing, man, with Janet. That's her name, man. I ain't never forget Janet, my little Pariqua, man, over there from Jamaica, Queens. You know, I was young, but, you know, anyways. I look at Bill Belichick and Cam Newton, and I'm like, man, this is a summer love, man. This is one of them crush, man. You know, you and I both know this is not going to end up going nowhere. We know at the end of the summer, we got to go our separate ways. We know that. But in the meantime, we're just going to enjoy it as we go. That's what's going on with Cam Newton and the New England Patriots. The Patriots right now, they're in a weird situation. You know what I'm saying? It's like they're in a weird situation. It's like they were the dynasty. And then all of a sudden, they're not like terrible. They're not like the Jags or, you know what I'm saying, the Bengals. But they're just at the middle of the tier team now. Now they're middle class. You know what I'm saying? Imagine you used to be high class and now they're middle class. They never want to go drop down to the poor. Like, no. They can't be poor. They can't be poor because they've been in a high class. If you go from high class to poor, oh, that's suicide. That's suicidal. That's when you see a lot of people, rich people just commit suicide. So the Patriots right now, they were the epitome of the high class, dropped down to the middle class, man. So now when you're in the middle class, you got different relationship shit. You got different issues, man. It's not the same as the high class. So this little puppy love with Cam Newton and Bill Belichick, yes, it's beautiful because it's, guess what? Because it's early in the summer. Oh, of course, because we just got here. I just met Janet. Oh, yeah, it feels good. Yeah, it's the beginning of the summer because I know I still got a few more weeks, man. But as it gets closer to the end of the season next year, as they get closer, a decision is going to come. A decision is going to come with the New England Patriots and Cam Newton. This little puppy love, this little band-aid, you know, this always happened. It's the last day, and I got to go back home. And Janet got to go back home. We got to go our separate ways. What are you going to do? Are you going to establish a long-distance relationship? Or are you just going to end it right then and there and just kill the band-aid? What you going to do? New England, yes, is the first month of the summer, first week. So, yeah, it feels good. It feels good right now with Cam Newton. Feels good. It feels like, yeah, the Patriots look like they're a playoff team. Oh my God, they won 7 games last year. Cam Newton, year 2. Nah, bro, you ain't fooling me, homie. I do not believe it, man. The AFC had gotten too good, man. The AFC have gotten better, and I don't think the New England Patriots have gotten better. And I think the addition of adding Cam Newton for another year stopped the bandit of making them worse, but it just retained them in the middle class, man. Because at the end of the summer, there's going to be a decision that's going to be made. And at the end of this season, New England, there's going to be a decision. Either you're going to get a real relationship, or you're going to continue your summer love, man. You know what I'm saying? So we're going to take a quick break. But when we come back, I got to talk about the Dak Prescott situation and that signing, because we missed it last week, man. When we did the show, the very next day, that's when he did his signing. So I'm going to give you all my thought on Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys, man. And this is Monday Morning Football with the Guru.